Hello everyone, so welcome to another BSR class. Today we will be dealing with fluid therapy, it is the most important chapter in entire veterinary science. Okay, fluid therapy, whatever you do, you have to give fluids in patient stable, whether it is patient stabilization, dehydration or anything, you have to give fluids. Okay, so this is the most important chapter, so pay attention. Okay, first of all, let us see which are the compartments in which fluids stay. Total body weight, I have taken 60% of body weight as total water. Okay, this is total water. Okay, in body, you see it varies. Okay, in young animal it may be up to 70%. Okay, or in older animals it may be less than 60%, but on an average I have taken 60% of body weight. Then it is divided in extracellular or intracellular compartment. So in intracellular compartment is the major portion. Okay, this is 40% of this 60%, while the extracellular is 20% of this 60%. Next, the extracellular compartment is again divided into the intravascular compartment and interstitial compartment. Okay, the intravascular compartment is 5%, the interstitial compartment is 15%. Understand here, you see this is blood vessel. Okay, so the intravascular compartment, fluid will travel through the interstitial compartment to the intracellular compartment. So these two compartments are basically extracellular, this is intracellular. This is further subdivided into intravascular and interstitial. You see, body composed of cells, so that is why the intracellular compartment is more. So it keeps the more water. Remember, most of the dehydration happens in these two compartments. Okay, the intravascular and interstitial compartment. Okay, if there is dehydration at intracellular level, the patient's condition will be worse. Okay, mostly these two. Let us take an example. Suppose there is a 20 kg dog, so there will be 12 liter water in his body, and this 12 liter is further subdivided intracellularly 8 liter and in extracellular space only 4 liter. Then it will be further subdivided, the intravascular will have 1 liter, then interstitial will be 3 liters. So let us take an example of a cat also. Suppose there is a 4 kg cat, small cat, so 2.4 liter will be water, which will further subdivided into 0.8 liter or 800 ml extracellularly, 1.6 liter intracellular. You see, intracellular is the major portion. Next, this 0.8 liter will be subdivided into 200 ml of intravascular volume, that is water only, and 600 ml of interstitial water. Next, calculation of blood. This is a thumb rule. If it's a dog, then 90 ml per kg. If this one is a 20 kg dog, you will find 1.8 liter of blood in his body or her body. Next, cat is 70 ml per kg body weight. So if you will take this 4 kg cat, you will find 280 ml of blood. Next, see, these are very important. Remember this, and while I will go for fluids, you will, in your brain, you calculate which fluids should be given. You see, simple dehydration or stress or exercise. Sometimes the animal on evening walk, if you are you have done so much of exercise, there will be dehydration, but the iron loss, there will be not much of iron loss. But in heat stroke, sodium and potassium, but this is variable. Okay, sometimes they actually vary. Sometimes there won't be any loss, sometimes there will be mild loss of potassium and sodium. Next, anorexia and starvation. These two, you will find these two cases in summer season also, most of the time, anorexia and starvation. In that case, potassium ion loss is more. And also vomiting, sodium potassium chloride. Then diarrhea, if it is an acute case, mostly sodium ion will be there. If it is a chronic case, then potassium ion loss will be there. You see, you will find many teachers saying vomiting is more serious business than diarrhea. Because of this, you see three ions are being lost, sodium, potassium and chloride. If you will get a case of persistent vomiting and persistent diarrhea, treat persistent vomiting first. Okay, because it is more serious business than the diarrhea. Now we will go for the fluids. So now we will understand fluids, different types of fluids. Mostly you will find crystalloid solutions, colloid solution, or blood or its products. Okay, First of all, crystalloid solution. Crystalloid can be of isotonic nature, hypotonic nature or hypertonic nature. Okay, depending on solute concentration. So examples of isotonic solution, 0.9% NaCl, you call this NS, normal saline. Okay, 0.9% NaCl. RL is Ringer's lactate. D5RS is Ringer's solution. Difference between Ringer's solution and Ringer's lactate is here you will find sodium lactate, where in Ringer's solution you find sodium bicarbonate. So plasma light. So these are examples of isotonic solution. Coming to hypotonic, the concentration 0.9% is isotonic. So concentration less than 0.9% is hypotonic. 0.45, 0.33, 0.225, D2.5, that is dextrose, 2.5 dextrose in water. Okay, this is hypotonic. Then hypertonic, okay, concentration more than 0.9%, 3% NaCl, 5% that is also 7% NaCl, then 5% dextrose in normal saline, 5% dextrose in RL, D10, D20, D50. Okay, all these are hypertonic solutions. Now we'll understand how they work. Isotonic solution, that means this is cell and this is the solution. The solute concentration is same. Okay, so the movement of water will be balanced. But in case of hypotonic, solute concentration in the solution is less, whereas the solute concentration in the cell is more. So water will transform from here to here. But in case of hypertonic, you see the solute concentration in the solution itself is very high, whereas in cell is low. So it will bring water into this. Okay, it will extract water from cell. Okay, it will give water into cell, where this one is more balanced. Now coming to the colloids. Okay, these are basically larger particles. Okay, examples are albumin, whether 5% or 25%, dextran and hetastars, this is more popular. And also you will find hemacil. Okay, I will tell composition of most common fluids in last. Okay, in hemacil you will find polygelin, a gelatin product, that is also a colloid. Okay, next, blood and its products, whether it is a fresh blood, stored blood or RBC. Now coming to how they maintain the fluids, I told that the dehydration is mostly from the extracellular space, that is whether from intravascular or the interstitial. Okay, the intravascular and interstitial, these are actually mostly comparative. Okay, so in case of if you are giving isotonic crystalloid solution, they will maintain the IV and IS, but not up to the mark, but they will maintain both in equal way. But in case of if you will give hypotonic, more of the solution will go to the interstitial, but the IV volume, there will be less IV volume. Same with hypotonic, but in case of the mechanism is different. Okay, I told you it will extract water from the cells to maintain the interstitial volume. Next, colloids. Colloid, in colloid the IV volume is very high. Okay, if you find any IV loss, suppose there is any bleeding, so colloids will give you better result because the intravascular volume will be maintained, whereas the interstitial volume is very less. And blood is the best. Okay, IV volume will be very much maintained and the interstitial space is less. Now coming to some advantage and disadvantage of these fluids. Okay, first of the crystalloid, there will be minimum coagulation problems. Okay, because there is no any particles which can hinder in coagulation problems. There won't be any anaphylaxis. Also the cost is low and there is wide range of availability. But the disadvantage is the IV non-maintenance of IV volume. I told you here, these are comparative. You see the IV volumes are not being maintained up to the level, and if you are giving more fluid, that is giving more than the required, you will find tissue edema. Next, the colloids, the advantage is rapid IV volume expansion even with lower volume. Okay, if you give comparative the crystalloid, even at lower volume, you will find very good rapid IV volume distribution because they are larger particles. Okay, they will extract water from interstitial cells also to maintain the blood volume or the IV volume. Then disadvantage is anaphylaxis. You see, most of the time you will find the anaphylaxis. For how to detect this, when giving the colloids, okay, for the first 2 to 5 minutes, give at a slow rate, okay. Check for any anaphylaxis reaction, then give fast, okay. So check this for anaphylaxis. Clotting result, this comes as a short question. It reduces the factor 8 and von Willebrand factor. Due to this reduction of these clotting factors, there will be problems in clotting. Then renal impairment, because you see these are larger particles, okay. Well, they will be excreted in through kidney. So while excretion, due to larger volume, it may cause renal impairment. Larger size, it may cause renal impairment. Then this one is actually costly compared to the crystalloid. Next, blood products. You will see rapid IV volume. Of course, it's blood. Then disadvantage is anaphylaxis and hemolysis. Anaphylaxis you can understand because there will be some potent and allergen. Then hemolysis, because if you will, there will be blood mismatch. Okay, here you remember the blood groups. In case of dog, it is dog erythrocyte antigen, DEA. Okay, whether it is 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 4, 5, 7. In case of cat, AB and AB. In case of dog, 1.1 is the most antigenic blood group. Okay, so you have to be very careful. This is all about the fluids. Now we'll go for the dose rates in mostly in dogs and cats. After that, I will tell you some commercial preparation and their composition. Now coming to the dose rate of different fluids. Okay, these two: crystalloid, colloid, and blood or blood product. First of all, the isotonic crystalloid solution. In case of dog, it is up to 90 ml per kg. It's up to 90 ml. These doses are mostly for moderate to severe dehydration. Severe dehydration is shock, moderate and severe for these dose rates are. You see, remember, for isotonic crystalloid for dogs and cats, the maintenance is 40 to 60 ml per kg. This one is maintenance. Okay, in mild dehydration or even if moderate dehydration, you can use this dose rate. Okay, so 90 ml per kg to effect, still till the effect has been seen. Okay, so if I'll take a 20 kg dog, for example, so you have to give 1.8 liter of fluid. Too much, you know. Okay, in cats it's 60 ml per kg. That is, if I'll take a 4 kg cat, I have to give 240 ml of isotonic crystalloid. I already gave the example of isotonic crystalloid. This is hypertonic saline, hypertonic crystalloid. Okay, you have to, the dose rate will be obviously less, 4 to 5 ml per kg. If it's a 20 kg dog, you have to give only 80 to 100 ml of saline in a rapid. So over 5 minutes, you have to give all. And remember, after giving the hypertonic saline, also give isotonic saline at the dose rate of 10 to 20 ml per kg. Okay, otherwise it may be detrimental. Okay, next, in case of cat, it's 3 to 4 ml per kg, same over 5 minutes. If it's a 4 kg cat, 12 to 16 ml only. Okay, after giving the hypertonic, give the isotonic fluid at the dose rate of 10 to 20 ml per kg body weight. Now coming to the crystalloids, dextran 70, the dose rate is 10 to 20 ml per kg. You have to give over 30 to 60 minutes. You see why the period is more. You see, for first few minutes, or for 5 to 7 minutes or 10 minutes, you have to give little slow to see whether there is anaphylaxis. Okay, so this one is 10 to 20 ml per kg over 30 to 60 minutes. If a 20 kg dog, it will be 200 to 400 ml over 30 to 60 minutes. You see, in case of cats, it's 5 to 10 ml per kg body weight. If it's a 4 kg cat, it will be 20 to 40 ml. Give it over 30 to 60 minutes. Next, hetastats. Actually, it's hydroxyethyl starch, hetastats, commonly in available in market as a vet plasma. Okay, by Zydus company, they are manufacturing vet plasma. The dose rate is 5 to 20 ml per kg body weight. It is usually rapid than the dextran injections, that is 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, if it's a 20 kg dog, you have to give 100 to 400 ml over 10 to 15 minutes. In case of cat, the dose rate is little less, 5 to 10 ml per kg body weight. If it's a 4 kg cat, 20 to 40 ml over 10 to 15 minutes. Next, 25% HSA. HSA is human serum albumin. Okay, the dose rate is 5 to 25 ml per kg body weight. If it's a 20 kg dog, give 100 to 500 ml over 10 to 15 minutes. And if it's a cat, dose rate is 5 to 25 ml per kg body weight. If it's a 4 kg cat, you have to give 20 to 100 ml over 10 to 15 minutes. These are colloids. Now coming to the blood, if it's a fresh or stored blood, then you have to give 10 to 20 ml per kg body weight. If it's a 20 kg dog, you have to give 200 to 440 ml per kg ml of the blood. You see, there is a formula also. 2.2 ml per kg will rise the PCV 1%. If you have a laboratory where you can calculate the PCV, then use this formula. This is better than the rough formula. Okay, if you do not have any laboratory or something, go with this dose rate. Okay, if I have the lab, then 44 ml will increase 1%. So if I want to give increase the PCV by 5%, I will give 220 ml. Next, in case of cat, it's 10 to 20 ml. It's basically same. If it's a 4 kg cat, I will give 40 to 88 ml. And if I have a lab, then I will calculate according to 8.8 ml will increase the PCV by 1%. Then packed RBC, the dose rate will be obviously less because you have extracted only the RBC. The dose rate is at the rate of 6 to 15 ml per kg body weight. If it's a 20 kg dog, then 120 to 300 ml you have to give. There is also a formula, 1 ml per kg will rise PCV by 1%. So if you have a lab, then calculate by 20 ml will increase PCV by 1%. If you want to increase PCV by 5%, then you have to give 100 ml only. Next, for cats, its dose rate is same. So if it's a 4 kg cat, you have to give 24 to 60 ml the blood, the packed RBC. If you have a lab, you can calculate by 4 ml of the packed RBC will rise the PCV by 1%. So these are basically moderate to severe dehydration or shock. See, these are, by this you can calculate the percentage of dehydration, whether it's mild, moderate or severe. The percentage in mild is less than 5%, for moderate 5 to 8%, severe is more than 8%. So STT is skin tinting test, CRT is capillary fill time. You can see in mild, both the will be 1 to 2 seconds, even if less than 1 second sometimes. Moderate, 2 to 3 seconds. Then severe, it's more than 3 seconds. Even sometimes it's not more than, even it may go up to 5 seconds, 7 seconds. Sometimes it won't come back to its normal position. Then you can check for the mucous membrane, the gums. The in mild, you will find semi-dry, slightly moist. In case of moderate, you will find dry mucous membrane. This is a very good finding in case of parvo cases. Okay, when the parvo cases will present after 2 to 3 days, you will find the mucous membrane dry. They will be in moderate stage. But after presentation of 4 to 5 days, it may be severely dry. Dehydration percentage may be more than 8%. So you have to go for accordingly. If there is moderate to severe, in moderate case go for lower dosage rate. In case of severe, go for higher dosage rate. This is all about the fluids. Next, I will go for some commercially available fluids and their composition, okay, for your information. But this is all about the fluid therapy. Now we'll go for some compositions, then we'll end. So now some commercially available preparations. Okay, NS is NaCl, sodium chloride. Then DNS is basically dextrose in normal saline. It is NaCl. Then Ringer's lactate, it contains sodium chloride, potassium chloride, calcium chloride and sodium lactate. Whereas Ringer's solution, sodium chloride, potassium chloride, calcium chloride and sodium bicarbonate. You see, if you refer to books, the bicarbonate ion is more towards basic side. So this is more balanced, okay. No doubt the RL is also balanced, but this is more balanced. Next, Rintos or Intalite. This is basically dextrogent RL. Okay, dextrose, sodium chloride, potassium chloride, calcium chloride and sodium lactate. This is nothing but the RL and this one is dextrose. Next is dextrose solution. Dextrose solution is basically dextrose in water, whether it is D5, D25, D20, D50 or anything. Octrose 25 is D25. Okay. Next is bed plasma. Bed plasma contains heta starch, hydroxyethyl starch. Next is hemacill. Hemacill basically contains polygelin as main ingredient, also KCl, NaCl and calcium chloride, CaCl2. Okay, this is comes under colloid, but this is also crystalloid. So it is a balanced and also it have both crystalloid and colloid properties. So you see, you put in comment section, you tell in case of vomiting, which fluids are suitable, in case of diarrhea, which fluids are suitable. You comment it. So this is all about the fluid therapy. So thank you very much. Next class we will go for the pre-operative preparations. Now what are the things you need to take care before moving the patient into anesthetic room. So this is all about today's class. Please like, share, subscribe. If you like this video, please share this video to the all the vets, whether senior, junior or any friends, colleagues, anyone. Thank you. Bye bye.